So far, my demonstrations have been from the point of view of an end user. Let's switch gears for a second and talk about how Helpdesk would leverage self-service password reset. So assuming you guys are getting 1,000 calls a month, a lot of people will be calling in and wanting you to reset your passwords over the phone. One of the challenges we have is to validate that the person on the phone matches the account that they're asking us to reset the password for, and that it's not somebody trying to maliciously get into an account. So one of the ways we can do that is to send them a token. We can send a token to their email address on file or to their mobile number on file. We can also ask some information about that user account that only that employee would know, such as their employee ID or any attribute that's in the directory. So when I log into self-service password reset, one of the modules we have here is the Helpdesk module. When I click on Helpdesk, I'm taken to a screen where I can type in names to search for different users. In this environment, I have a couple of test users, Juliet and Natasha Xline. So let's take Juliet for a second. On the first tab here, you'll notice I have a profile page that shows me basic information about that profile. So I can display their current email address, their title. I could customize this if I wanted to include additional attributes. On the status tab, I've got status for this particular object. So I can see that person's full email address. I can see which OU they've been created in. I can also see their SMS number, whether their account is enabled or not, and also whether their password is expired, etc. I've got a lot of good information here that I can use just to validate this object. We also have password history information. So I'm able to leverage the audit log and self-service password reset and see exactly when the account was created, when they set up their responses, and if they've updated any of their attributes, that will also be recorded. And finally, I have a tab here that shows me the password policy that's being assigned to this object. So I can use this if I wanted to discuss with the user about the requirements for setting up their password after I change it. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see I've got the change password option. We'll get back to that in a second. Below that, I have an unlock button. So if this user account was locked out, I could unlock their account from here. If this user was unable to use self-service password reset because they have forgot their challenge response questions, this is where we're able to come in and clear those answers. Once they're cleared out and the user logs into the solution the next time, we'll automatically get those again for the user. There is an option here to have an OTP secret, so I can define an OTP secret for that user. When they need that, they can provide that. If they forget that, this is where you would come to clear it out. The verify button is how I would verify users that are on the phone. And as I talked about in the beginning, there's a couple of ways to do that. One being user data, the second being token verification. So this environment is set up to validate their postal code. I've seen it in production environments where it would validate their manager or their employee ID. I can also come here and send out that token. I can choose from the dropdown whether I want it sent to their email address or their smartphone. I've gone ahead and sent it to that person's smartphone, and I'll let them read that token back to me. If I validate the token and everything comes back successfully, then I know the person on the phone is the person I have right now in this view, and I'm able to go ahead and change their password without impacting anybody else. So let me go ahead and input the security code. All right, what happened there? So something didn't go right. Let me resend this token. All right, let's do this one more time. I'll verify the token. Success. So I know the person on the phone is this Juliet Xline test user that I have set up here. I can now proceed with changing their password. So from here, I can type in a password that I want, or of course, we also have random passwords that we can select. So if I wanted to choose that random password, I hit OK, and bingo, that user has now been changed. They can now log into the solution and change their password to something unique that's not known by me or anybody else and start using their account again.